Hi, welcome back to another episode of Hungover Genetics. I'm your host, James Hung, and today we'll be talking about TAC polymerase, the workhorse of modern-day polymerase chain reaction. Let's turn back time and travel to when it all first started. 1969, here we go! TAC, also known as Thermus aquaticus, was discovered by Thomas Brock in the hot springs of Yellowstone National Park. These hot springs have temperatures ranging from 92 degrees Celsius to a whopping 135 degrees Celsius. Its discovery was a huge surprise as many scientists believed that cellular proteins would denature at this temperature. Inspired by this, many researched about these proteins. While their contributions helped us understand more about thermophiles, a piece of the puzzle was still missing as we still lacked knowledge about their DNA polymerases. In 1976, Alice Chien and her colleagues began their quest on understanding the DNA polymerase of Thermus aquaticus. After cultivating a large amount of Thermus aquaticus, the cells were broken up to release their cellular content. The mixture was centrifuged at high speed to isolate the DNA polymerase of Thermus aquaticus. It was subsequently named TAC polymerase. Numerous tests were performed on this enzyme. The first test was to find the optimal temperature for TAC polymerase. Using a Packard scintillation spectrometer, the enzymatic activity of TAC polymerase was quantified by the mass of radioactive thymidine triphosphate that was integrated into an acid-insoluble product. The greater the mass of radioactive DTTP, the higher the enzymatic activity. By repeating the test at multiple temperatures, Alice Chien and the team found that TAC polymerase has its peak activity at 80 degrees Celsius, which was significantly higher than previously discovered thermophiles. Subsequently, an exonuclease assay was performed. Exonuclease activity is an important aspect of DNA polymerases, as it reflects the ability of the enzyme to preserve the integrity of the original genome by removing any mismatched base pairs. This assay involved the incubation of TAC polymerase with radioactive labeled lambda DNA. If TAC polymerase does possess exonuclease activities, lambda DNA would be broken down and radioactive nucleotides would be released into the solution. There was a total of 5 setups. The first setup did not contain any TAC polymerase. The second had TAC polymerase only. The third had TAC polymerase and 2 millimolar of ATP. The fourth contained RNase A, which hydrolyzes RNA, and the fifth contained pancreatic DNase 1, which hydrolyzes DNA. Of these 5 setups, radioactivity was only detected in the solution containing pancreatic DNase 1. This meant that even in the presence of ATP, TAC polymerase lacked exonuclease activity, hence suggesting it has poor proofreading abilities. Alright, enough about TAC polymerase. Let's switch gears and talk about polymerase chain reaction. In 1983, while driving, Carey Mullis conceptualized this technique. He wanted to use 2 sets of DNA sequences, also known as primers, to flank out specific regions of DNA for amplification. His ideas turned into reality, and in 1985, PCR made its debut. Using DNA polymerases of E. coli, Psyche and his team successfully amplified DNA for the detection of sickle cell anemia. However, the process was tedious. As the first step of PCR involved raising the temperature to 95 degrees Celsius to separate the double-stranded DNA, DNA polymerase of E. coli was often denatured too. As a result of that, scientists had to manually replace the enzyme after every cycle. Now this is the point of time when history was changed forever. In 1988, Carey Mullis finally found a solution. Instead of using the DNA polymerase of E. coli, he used TAC polymerase. Remember how it can withstand extreme heat and works best at 80 degrees Celsius? Yes, 12 years after the discovery of TAC polymerase, it finally made its impact in the scientific community. PCR was no longer labor-intensive and many cycles could be performed all within a thermocycler without the need to replace any enzyme. PCR and TAC polymerase became an inseparable pair and they were widely used throughout the biotech industry. and in 1989, Journal of Science named tech polymerase as the molecule of the year. Now, back to 2022. Many new forms of PCR have been developed, but tech polymerase remains to be the indispensable ingredient. In the recent pandemic, PCR and tech polymerase once again came into play as it was used as a form of diagnostic test for COVID-19. Alright, that's it for today. Hope you enjoyed today's episode. Hungover Genetics signing out.